पूर्णात् पूर्णमुदच्यते पूर्णस्य पूर्णमादाय पूर्णमेवावशिष्यते। ॐ शांति शांति शांति। Just a small correction. When we chant Purnamada, after Purnamada there is a visarga, and if visarga is followed by pa, so visarga is not pronounced, it is pronounced as half pa. So it should be Purnamadaf Purnamidam. Half, if visarga double dot is followed by pa, so you have to make that half, that visarga pronounced as half. So it should be Purnamadah, Purnamadaf half. Purnamadaf Purnamidam, like that. Om Hara Namah Parvati Pate. You can't pronounce the visarga there. So this is a sandhi rule. Okay. One point. Second point in Purnamadah, it is like that. Om Hara, you should go down. Om Purnamadav Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnameva Vashishyate. Wherever Rana is there, you go down there. If you want very accurate pronunciation, anything we do, we should fine-tune it every day. Only people pronounce anything, Om Purnamada Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate. But when you become little serious student, our sensitivity to everything increases. I want to pronounce this accurately. And another is one point I told also, Om Shanti. Sha should go down. Shanti Shanti, Shanti. But at all other Shanti mantras, Sha is not going down. Om Sahana Bhavatu, Sha doesn't go down. There it is Om Shanti, Ta goes down. Shanti, Shanti, Shanti. So last Ta goes up, and in Purnamada is the only mantra where last Ta goes down and all Sha are down. If you have Mantra Pushpam book, in that you can, you have Mantra Pushpam. I don't know any book is there or not. You can see this. Just check in the book stall if we can have any book. So you will get that. Okay. So, Om Purnamadav Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate पूर्णस्य पूर्णमादाय पूर्णमेवावशिष्यते। ओम शांति शांति शांति। इट हैज टू बी मोर रिफाइंड फॉर्म। ओके, सो एवरी डे वी शुड चेंज स्लाइटली। नाउ कमिंग बैक टू अवर मंत्र विच वाज देयर, होप we'll complete this mantra, this session, I hope only. 5 points were raised by Purmimamsa. And last point was very beautiful point that Purvamimamsa said, because you are not doing anything and therefore what is the prayojan? You are knowing doesn't give any fruit. And one point which was raised by was that knowing itself can give a fruit if your problem is by ignorance. Beautiful point. We rarely feel that our problem is ignorance. If you remember first class, when I said situationist was there. Then second was who feels good actions. Then third was Ishwar. Then fourth was, ultimately it was that my problem, because Dukkham is inside, therefore cause of Dukkha is also inside, and the cause of my sorrow is my ignorance about the Self. And I am repeating it. I like that a lot, therefore I am repeating this. Because sorrow is not an objective, it is a subjective mistake of thinking ourselves smaller. Sense of loss in I have lost. I have lost. I am alone. I am hurt. I was cheated. I was humiliated. All these words are on I. Moment you put these things in I, that I becomes shorter, and then experience of sorrow is there. I'm just giving an example. Supposing somebody insulted, and you keep on thinking, I was insulted. You'll find that sorrow becomes very big in the mind. You practice it. All practices are required. And just for sadhana, you just say, verbally say, body's insult, not mind. Body's insult, not mind. Body's insult is there. It has nothing to do with it. You just repeat this. And you will see that intensity of sorrow has lessened within 2-3 minutes only. This is what I was saying. This is called meditation. When you repeat the words of the teacher without any aid, without external aid, without external aid of book, of copy, you bring forcefully those thoughts at will, and then you will feel sorrow has lessened. This is one way. If you are not a jnani kind of person, you love a lord, then I'll tell you another way. Then when sorrow comes, you use one word, good, God, good you gave the sorrow to me. Good you gave a sorrow to me. Good you gave a sorrow to me. Associate God with the sorrow. Your God will become bigger, sorrow will become smaller. But never experience sorrow without knowledge of the Self or without God. There was one amma, I used to tell in Prayagraj, I went there. Somebody's mother, she was very divine. So she was on the deathbed almost. Pain was there. So when pain was there, she used to constantly say one thing, thank you God, thank you God, thank you, thank you. And therefore pain didn't become sorrow. I was mentioning in the morning, dard aur dukh ek nahi hota. जब दिल का दर्द होता है तो दुख हो जाता है. सो शी यूज टू से थैंक यू गॉड एंड इन हर माइंड गॉड बिकेम वन. सो आइदर ऑफ द प्रैक्टिस यू डू इट, आई होप यू विल ट्राई. एंड दिस इज विद एनी इशू. हाँ, सपोजिंग समबडी लेफ्ट यू, समबडी सेड बैड थिंग्स टू यू, समबडी cheated you, somebody dished you, or you lost somebody very dear, some person you lost. होल स्क्रिप्चर रामायण महाभारत भगवद गीता दे आर हाईली एंटी सॉरो। अरे भगवान कृष्ण ने तो इतना चिल्लाया है। इन सेकेंड चैप्टर इफ यू रीड भगवद गीता, ओ माई गॉड, न तुम सोचो तुम अरहसी, न तुम सोचो तुम अरहसी, न तुम सोचो, आई थिंक 5-6 टाइम, यू आर नॉट वर्दी ऑफ ग्रीविंग, यू आर नॉट। ही स्टार्टेड भगवद गीता इन सेकेंड चैप्टर, गतासून गतासूंश्च नानु शोचन्ति पंडिता, होल थिंग ही स्टार्टेड विद अ रिप्रिमेंडिंग अर्जुन, बोल यू आर टॉकिंग लाइक ज्ञानी, अशोच्यान अन्व शोचस्तम, दोज आर नॉट वर्दी ऑफ ग्रीविंग यू आर ग्रीविंग ऑन देम। प्रज्ञावाचा भाषा से, डोंट थिंक ही टोल्ड इन अ वेरी मेलोडियस वॉइस। ही चांटेड द श्लोक अशोच्यान अशोचस्तम प्रज्ञावादाश भाषा से, ऐसे बोलते हो तुम। गतासून गतासूंश्च नानु शोचन्ति पंडिता, ये तो शोचन्ति ते पंडिता न भवन्ति। दिस इज द मेन सेंटेंस ऑफ गीता एंड प्रूव दिस इज होल गीता। गीता पढ़ो तो समझ में आएगा। सो बाय नोइंग ओनली अवर सॉरो गोज अवे एंड होल अर्जुन, दिस इज कॉल्ड प्रतिज्ञा वाक्य इन द लैंग्वेज ऑफ न्याय, इट इज कॉल्ड प्रतिज्ञा वाक्य। सम वर्ड्स यू हैव टू फेमिलराइज इन न्याय, दे यूज तर्क शास्त्र एंड वन इज कॉल्ड प्रतिज्ञा, हाँ हेतु, थर्ड दृष्टांत, फोर्थ विवरण, फिफ्थ निगमन। दिस इज कॉल्ड पंचांग ऑफ न्याय। जस्ट लिसन टू इट, क्या फर्क पड़ता है। सम वर्ड्स वी शुड लिसन, वेन यू लिसन देन यू बी क्यूरियस व्हाट इट इज, सो वील सी दैट। This is the main sentence. So just by knowledge only, whole chapter, Arjun was very happy. He said, Nashto moha smritra labdha, tat prasadat mayachyuta, isthitosmi gata sandeha, karishe vachanam tava. He had to say that. And he can't lie in front of Lord. Don't lie in front of Lord. In front of lawyer, Lord, and astrologer, don't lie. And teacher. These four places, if you lie, you will be caught. Because astrologer will immediately see the chart. And exactly if your astrologer is very good, he can pinpoint on that day, he will say on that day, this time this person is, what is his state of mind? He is lying or he is not lying. The word he said. And lawyer also can catch you. See, Supreme Court rejected Chidambaram's bail plea. Just now. Huh? Hey, 10:46 a.m. He appealed for a bail plea, the INX case. Just now I was reading. He rejected. Bhagwan ke samne kya jhoot bola? And you know Bhagwan's compassion, you see in Bhagavad Gita. 18th chapter was over. And you know what Bhagwan said? Kachit agyan sammoha pranashtaste dhananjaya. What I taught, is your ignorance gone? Agyan sammoha. He didn't change the situation. Neither he put hand on the head of Arjun. Kitna easy ho jata. Neither he gave any kind of mystic experience. Kuch nahi bole. Bole, kachit agyan sammohaha pranashtaste dhananjaya. Bole, oh Arjun, your agyan has gone or not? Otherwise, thank God Arjun said, we would have studied more chapter. Oh, to Arjun ki problem, hamari problem. Chalta hi rehta phir. Because Lord is compassionate. Compassionate teacher doesn't give up. The shri of a teacher is that he doesn't accept defeat. How much a student may be going up and down, he said, I won't give you, I will see again, I'll explain to you. ये तो जगत गुरु हैं भाई, कृष्णम वंदे जगत गुरु। ये राम जी के लिए नहीं बोला, कृष्णम वंदे जगत गुरु। वो बोलेगा तुम फिर से पूछो हमसे, हम फिर बताएंगे तुमको। सो हियर द नॉलेज इज विथ प्रयोजन बिकॉज इट टेक्स अवे ऑल द सॉरोज। दिस वॉज द फिफ्थ पॉइंट। आई एम नॉट गोइंग टू रिपीट द फाइव पॉइंट, प्लीज गो थ्रू इट वंस मोर, इट इज नॉट डिफिकल्ट एट ऑल। इफ समथिंग इज डिफिकल्ट आई विल रिपीट। नाउ लास्ट पॉइंट इज द सिक्स्थ पॉइंट। पूर्वमीमांसा सेज बोले यू आर एस्टेब्लिशिंग योर व्यू बाय गिविंग वेरियस रीजनिंग। बोले यस, बट आई हैव द लास्ट पॉइंट टू से। कैन आई से दैट? बोले ऑफ कोर्स यू शुड से। हु सेड डोंट से दैट? व्हेन यू हैव सेड सो मेनी थिंग्स यू कैन से दिस आल्सो। ही सेड आत्मा एव इति उपासीत, दिस इज द विद्या सूत्रम। यस, कैन आई टॉक अबाउट ग्रामेटिकल पोर्शन विच आई हैड रीज्ड? बोले यस यस, आई हैव थ्री इशूज इन दैट। बोले वॉट आर द थ्री इशूज? फर्स्ट इज इट इज एंडिंग इन त, विच इज अ विधि लिंग इफ यू रिमेंबर आई सेड, पोटेंशियल फॉर्म। सो बिकॉज हियर इट इज नॉट ओनली शाब्दी भावना, इट इज आर्थी भावना। दैट मीन्स यू टू डू समथिंग। ओके, अच्छा, दिस इज द फर्स्ट पॉइंट। येस ऑफकोर्स, लेट मी कंप्लीट, देन यू कैन पुट योर पॉइंट। सेकेंड पॉइंट इज दिस उपास आस वर्ड इज देयर, आस धातु इज देयर, सेकेंड कॉन्जुगेशन धातु इज देयर आस, एंड उप मीन्स टू सिट। बोल ठीक है। सो उपास मीन्स इज टू मेडिटेट अपॉन, टू dwell, टू मेडिटेट। यस, उपासते, उपासाते एंड उपासते, दिस फॉर्म इट गोज इन संस्कृत। ओके, दोज हु आर संस्कृत स्टूडेंट दे विल अंडरस्टैंड। एंड थर्ड पॉइंट इज इति वर्ड हैज बीन यूज्ड। बोले ठीक है, इति वर्ड हैज बीन यूज्ड, आई एग्री विद दैट। नो, बट इति वर्ड इन जनरल इज यूज्ड फॉर उपासना ओनली, पूर्वमीमांसा से। इति वर्ड, सो इति वर्ड इज यूज टू विजुअलाइज समथिंग ऑन समथिंग एल्स, दैट इज कॉल्ड उपासना। शालिग्राम में विष्णु उपासित, ऑन शालिग्राम यू डू विजुअलाइज ऑफ लॉर्ड विष्णु। ओके, अच्छा, शिवलिंगे शिव उपासित, ऑन द शिवलिंग यू विजुअलाइज लॉर्ड शिव। हरिद्रा गणेशे गणपतिम उपासित, हरिद्रा, हरिद्रा मीन्स टर्मरिक, हल्दी, टर्मरिक, दे मेक आउट ऑफ टर्मरिक, यू डू उपासना ऑफ गणपति। सो व्हेन इट इज सेड आत्मा एव उपासित इति, सो दैट मीन्स देयर इज समथिंग एल्स ऑन विच आत्मा शुड बी सीन। So I have these three objections. You can imagine how much intellectual honesty is there. That Bhagwan Bhashyakar raises the question. He could have skipped the question. And he could have jumped and put his point and justified. He said, any question you have, you can ask. Three questions. First is ending is the. Second is उपास, verb itself means to do upasana, that means to upasana, you don't understand, repeating of the thoughts. Upasana is a manas vyapar, you repeat the thoughts, like Om Namah Shivaya, Om Namah Shivaya, Om Namah Shivaya, Om Namah Shivaya. In knowledge you don't repeat the thought, you understand. One is called Purush Tantra, other is called Vastu Tantra. This is a paperweight, understood. I did not repeat, this is paperweight, this is paperweight, this is paperweight. But if I am doing upasana, athar shirsh, you have to repeat it. It is a manas vyapar. Om Namaste Ganapate Tameva Pratyaksham Brahmasi Tameva. You continue that. Avartan it is called, Sahasravartam.
आवर्तन रिपीटिशन ओके इन नॉलेज यू डोंट हैव टू रिपीट यू रिपीट द अंडरस्टैंडिंग यू आई वॉज यूजिंग द वर्ड यू रिट्रीव योर अंडरस्टैंडिंग वन गुड वर्ड इज रिट्रीव दिस इज कंप्यूटर पीपल यूज दिस आई एम रिट्रीविंग द डेटास माई हार्ट इज क्रैश आई हार्ट इज क्रैश एंड आई एम रिट्रीविंग द लॉस्ट डेटास अच्छा कुड यू रिट्रीव हाफ आई कुड रिपीट स्टिल आई एम गोइंग आई एम ट्राइंग टू फाइंड आउट हाफ इट इज इम्पॉर्टेंट रिट्रीविंग सो इन नॉलेज यू रिट्रीव द हिडन नॉलेज एंड ब्रिंग एट द सर्फेस ऑफ योर माइंड एंड इन उपासना यू रिपीट एंड इंग्लिश वर्ड मेडिटेशन इज यूज फॉर बोथ वेरी वन वर्ड इज देयर इट वॉज अ प्री मेडिटेटेड मर्डर So here that meditation is very well thought of, well planned, well organized. There the meaning is not of repetition. Where you superimpose something on something else, nikrisht vastuni utkrisht bhavana iti upasana. On something small you superimpose a very big thought, matra devo bhava. I can see she is my mother only. Yandana, seeing mother as mother is not a upasana. It is true. It is jnana. But this comes in Taittiriya Upanishad. Matra Devo Bhava. And there in the Bhashya, when I say Bhashya means commentary, Shankaracharya Bhagavan writes, Devat Upasitavyam. That means on the mother, you don't see as a mother. You see as a god. So, nikrisht vastnu utkrisht bhava, upasana. I was using the word pervasive thought in the beginning when we were seeing sadhan prapanch. Then we were using the word. So, in upasana, you repeat a pervasive thought so that you get out of a small mind. In knowledge, You repeat the understanding, not the thought. I will again tell how I am drishta and this is the body's drishya. I am not repeating a particular thought in a particular tone, like Gayatri Mantra. I am repeating my understanding in different ways. Today I applied this way, tomorrow I will apply another way. I am retrieving the understanding. Which is hidden in me. So that is called upas. And not upvas, upas. And third was iti word is again used when upasana is completed, then this is used. This is my objection. So Shankaracharya said, okay, now I will answer all your points. Only okay. I will not ask anything else. This was my last doubt. Only okay. So, here he says, here's upas word is not for visualization. Why? Every word should be taken in the context. Before this section, ध्यान देके सुनना एंड आफ्टर दिस सेक्शन ओनली टॉपिक ऑफ नॉलेज इज गोइंग ऑन इन बिटवीन ऑल ऑफ अ सडन रैंडमली श्रुति विल नॉट टॉक आउट अबाउट उपासना आई एम टॉकिंग अबाउट कैलकटा फॉर द लास्ट हाफ एन आवर एंड आई यूज्ड वन वर्ड बैनियन ट्री Banyan tree should be seen. And then again I talked about Calcutta. If I am sensible, if I am disciplined talker, those who are indisciplined, they talk any erratic thing. This is a Rishi, this is a Ishwarvani. It's not a Manushyavani. When I said Banyan tree in between, then you have to understand that banyan tree, I think he must be talking something about Calcutta then. Then you have to think, okay, is there some banyan tree in Calcutta? Famous banyan tree is there. Biggest banyan tree. I didn't mention the whole thing, but I used.
Then you have to say, you are talking about the Calcutta banyan tree. What is it called? Botanical garden is there. I think biggest banyan tree is there.
More than 150 years.
Oh my God. And they had lot of secondary branches, tertiary roots all around. It is very famous.
I mean, before that, Pravesh Shruti was mentioned. After this mantra, again the Vedantic talk will be there. Then how come in between the topic of visualization will come?
Okay. See, aise sochte hain log. This is called, and those who are indisciplined thinking, you know how they talk. Swamiji, when is your yagna? What chapter are you taking? Second chapter, acha. Second chapter of Gita? Yes. Acha, acha. What is in second chapter? Second chapter, this karma yoga is there. Acha, hum gulab jamun khate? Matlab, there is the topic is going on something. From where to where? This is called indisciplined thinking. There is no linking of two points. And if sudden topic has to be changed, a disciplined thinker will say, sorry, but I am digressing. He will always be aware that I am taking another subject. He will say, sorry, I am digressing, but I had one inquiry. I will again come to that topic. But this was my curiosity because I had to give something. Then he may think like that. Always keep a track of the latter thought and previous thought. Acha, this is one point upas word is there. And therefore many times I said, please see the word in its context. Okay. Lion word is there. A lion may not mean the lion in the jungle. He's the lion among human beings. Punjab Kesari. Lala Lajpat Rai was called Punjab Kesari. Lion doesn't mean that lion. Or he may be... I was going in Lions Club once in a talk. Then they said, Lion P.K. Gupta will welcome. I thought some lion will... So that person was a small, short person. Oh, their lion is another meaning. You have to see what is the context of that. Okay. Foolish. A foolish word does not mean foolish. Somebody whom you love a lot, you can use the word is. Tum bekoof ho. Uriya Baba ji, when he used to love somebody, bole bekoof hai ye. It is the way of expressing your closeness to that person. Someone who are too close, and still that person is smiling. When you say he is foolish, he is very happy. So you have to say, you cannot say that, you know, that Guruji said to him foolish or pagal bola. Oh, pyar mein pagal bola hoga usko. Kya mood tha, kya context tha? Frozen word is there. Frozen doesn't mean the freezer has frozen. Accounts may be frozen. Income tax raided, and he froze all the accounts of bank of this person. Or seeing that the lady entered the house, seeing the burglars, the thief, she froze. Froze has another meaning there. Okay. Man word. Man does not mean all the time man. Man may be used as someone assertive also. Be like a man. live like a man. Gurudev used to joke about Indira Gandhi. He used to say she was the only man in her womanly cabinet. Gurudev's puns and his sense of humor and brilliance was just amazing. She was the only man in her womanly cabinet. Every word has a meaning. So upas word has this meaning. Number 2 point. Third termination you are giving quite a vidhiling again and again. You are saying, so this grammatically, bole purupaksh, you are talking about this grammatically. Bole yes. Bole grammatically don't make very big issue out of it. Because certain places in your karmakand also, commandment is not given, but you take it as a commandment. Bole yes. So when you can take something, when commandment is not there, and sometimes you see, there is no commandment. So I say it is good to get, so, you know, our teacher says, I got up early in the morning. There is no commandment. But students understand what is the hidden meaning. A good student will immediately catch that my teacher is asking, this is implied meaning is, that when I get up, you also should get up. He did not say that you should get up. He will say, when I was a student like you, I used to get up before the teacher gets up. Rather, I used to warm the water and put in his wash bathroom after me taking bath. I'm just telling him. Supposing he is using that. There is no commandment directly. But implied meaning is something else. Similarly, it is possible that it may be appearing like a commandment, but it is not a commandment. It is not a commandment. Supposing again sometime teacher is upset. He said, go. Leave the ashram. Leave the ashram does not mean literally leave the ashram. Then what does it mean? Or you say, go out, leave the place. You are not fit. It only means that I am upset. Do some tapasya to get out of that. That is not work. All the time commandment should not be taken as commandment, because this context is not of commandment. Praveshuti has been mentioned. The whole Upanishad will be talking about the Atma. And I told there are two chapters in Madhu Kand. One was about Adhyarop, other was about Apavad. The context is the Atma Brahma Ek Bodh. And therefore, you don't go grammatically too much. So there is a grammatical flaw. Our side also there can be grammatically flaw, and your side also there can be grammatically flaw. For which you are wrong, don't tell me that I am wrong. Two drunkards can't say to each other, you don't drink. Okay, when both are drunk, you cannot say. They say those who have glass houses, those should not throw stones. So grammatically, if I start, I can also catch many statements like that. So sometimes you use the word, although there is no indication, but there is a commandment. And sometimes there is no commandment, still there is a commandment. I hope this is. So, this is the, you say, bhavana is indicated in the mind. Okay, commandments means arthi bhavana. Don't forget these technical words. Technical words are very communicative. If I use in English, same arthi bhavana, Sanskrit is a very, it puts in capsule form. What's long statements, it can put in 2-3 words.
Now, Arthi Bhavana means the notion born in the mind that I should do some this. Itna lamba statement ho gaya. Notion after Shabdi Bhavana, I heard, notion born in the mind that I should do. Teacher said, Jab should be done. Teacher said to the student, every day, Jab should be done. Students are very regular. Bole Mahi Guruji has said, Jab should be done. Ab now this was Shabdi Bhavana. It went into mind. Bole, what Jab I should do? How I should do? And by what means? So I take Rudraksh Mala, Tulsi Mala, Spatik Mala. Kaun si Mala karein? Kab karein? Subah baithein? Shaam ko baithein? How to do? By what means to do? These three questions will not allow arise after Atma is being talked of. Why? Because when Atma alone are there is no akanksha left after that. Desire is about something which is other than you. When Atma is known as the Purna and other than nothing exists, there is nothing more to desire. There is nothing more to do. Who will do, on what will be done, by what will be done, for there are seven cases in Sanskrit. They are called karakas. Bolega koi? Karak. हाँ कर्ता कर्म करण फोर्थ संप्रदान फिफ्थ अपादान सिक्स संबंध अधिकरण इंग्लिश में बोल दें डूअर एक्शन इंस्ट्रूमेंट फोर्थ डेटिव फिफ्थ एबिलिटिव सिक्स पजेसिव सेवेंथ लोकेटिव I think this must be taught in the school only. Ram went to house. So house is karma bhakti. Ram went to house by bicycle. This is tritiya. Ram went to house by bicycle for eating. Fourth ho gaya. Ram from the office. Ab you can feel, I won't say the whole thing. Ram from the office went to house by bicycle for eating. Ram of his mother Kaushalya or Shanti of possessive ho gaya. Ram of Shanti from the office went to the house by bicycle for eating. Ram राम इन काशी इन वाराणसी लोकेटिव हो गया राम इन काशी ऑफ हिज मदर फ्रॉम द ऑफिस बाय द बाइसिकल वेंट टू हिज हाउस फॉर ईटिंग ये कवर्ड ऑल अधिकरण ठीक है ना हाँ बोला आई कुड ओनली राइट राम No. I will only say, and I'll tell in one word. On, by, for, from, of, in. हिंदी में बोल दे इसको बोलो भाई हिंदी वाले हैं हाँ हिंदी वाली बैठी है वहाँ पे हाँ वो तो हो गया वो एक एक शब्द बोलो इसको को से के लिए उससे उसका उन पे इसको बोलते हैं कारक कारक क्या होता है That which is accessories to action is called karak. Like I'm talking to you with the mic from my knowledge of belonging to the mission. In this vibhuti. सो वेर एवर एक्शन इज इन्वॉल्व ये कारक आ जाएंगे.
ओ
भाष्यकार इज सेइंग टेल मी आफ्टर द नॉलेज विच कारक रिमेन्स. है कारक कहां से बनेगा? बोले कर्ता. कर्ता इंक्लूड मॉडिफिकेशन, देयर इज नो कर्ता. बोले टू, आत्मा के अलावा है नहीं तो टू कहां से आएगा, उस पर कहां से आएगा? फ्रॉम आत्मा किसी को बिलोंग नहीं करता. बोले आत्मा की कोई मां होगी? नहीं, कोई मां नहीं आत्मा. आत्मा कहीं जाएगा किसी के लिए आत्मा होगा? आत्मा किसी के लिए है नहीं. देखो तुम बेकार की बात करोगे तो मार पड़ेगी. आत्मा किसी के लिए है नहीं. वो आत्मा ही है जो सर्वव्यापी है, जो नित्य है, जो सर्वगत है, हाँ, जो निर्विकार है, जो निराकार है, जो चेतन है. इसमें ये कोई कारक नहीं काम करते. कारक तभी आएगा जहां दो एक ही सत्ता के होंगे. एंड देयरफॉर आर्थी भावना बनेगी नहीं इस स्टेटमेंट को सुनने पे. वन हु हैज द नॉलेज ऑफ आत्मा ही विल हैव नो एजेंसी फॉर्म्ड इन द इंटेलेक्ट फॉर आर्थी भावना.
ओके ओके. एंड देयरफॉर सर्वाकांक्षा निवृत्ति भवति. देयर इज नो डिजायर आफ्टर. देयर इज नो क्वेश्चन एज कमांडमेंट. एंड देयरफॉर थ्री वर्ड्स विच यू हैड यूज्ड, द एंडिंग उपास्ते एंड इति, ऑल आई हैव प्रूव्ड दैट दिस स्टेटमेंट इज नॉट अ कमांडमेंट, इट इज जस्ट अ नॉलेज. बोले ओके, आई एक्सेप्ट इट. अब क्या कर सकते हैं? वॉट इज द कंक्लूजन? कंक्लूजन इज वन हु नोज आत्मा एज ब्रह्मन. सो वॉट डज इति सेज? इति सेज विदाउट डाउट. इति इज फॉर असर्शन. विदाउट डाउट वन हु नोज आत्मा एज द ब्रह्मन विदाउट ऑब्जेक्टिफाइंग. वन शुड नो आत्मा. वन हु इज नोइंग आत्मा विदाउट एज ब्रह्मन विदाउट ऑब्जेक्ट. अविषय बोधनार्थम इति शब्द. अविषय बोधनार्थम इति शब्द. इति शब्द इज टू टेल नॉन ऑब्जेक्टिफिकेशन. हाँ, अविषय बोधनार्थम इति शब्द. सो वन हु नोज ब्रह्मन एज आत्मा. So one is the, what is the substratum of the world is my sakshi. Avishaya bodhanartham iti shabda. Now this concludes this topic of atma. This, what was the name of this? Vidya sutra. And this bhashya is called Vidya sutra bhashya. If you want to study, you study. I have tried to condense it. I have tried to make it more acceptable so that you don't get lost in the grammar, in the words. If you read the Bhashya and if your Sanskrit is not great, I am not only hoping but I am confident you will get lost. But after having this background, now if you read that, you will have very much clarity. Without Sanskrit, you will all understand at least 60-70%. When you have free time, then you can just loudly read. Loudly. Don't murmur in your room. And when you will read it, you will see, oh, this was said. Oh, this was said. Oh, this was said. Okay.